Hey everyone, welcome back to another video from Random Shashi. In this video, we are going to make our own NAS or network attached storage server at home using the Raspberry Pi 4B. For those who doesn't know what a NAS is, it is basically a storage device that can be accessed from any device in your network. So without any further ado, let's jump into the video. To make our server, we'll be using the following items. First of all, the Raspberry Pi 4B 4GB RAM variant, a Raspberry Pi case with a case fan, and I'll be using a 500GB SATA hard disk that I have lying around for storage, a Raspberry Pi USB-C power adapter, a SATA to USB with external power supply, and at last, we have a 32GB micro SD card. Now let's write PiOS into the SD card. For that, insert the SD card into your PC and go to this link which is given in the description and download Raspberry Pi OS Lite. After that's done, go and download Balena itself, the link to which is also in the description. Now install and run Balena itself and select the option Flash from File. Before that, you shouldn't forget to extract the image of PiOS Lite from the zip file you downloaded. Now choose the image file and make sure you select the correct SD card and click Flash. After it's done flashing, remove and reinsert the SD card. Now open the boot partition of the SD card and type CMD on the address bar and press enter. Now type echo space greater than symbol space SSH and press enter. As you can see, a new file named SSH has been created. Now let's assemble our Raspberry Pi NAS. Now let's plug in our Raspberry Pi and go back to our PC. And now go to the link given in the description and download Angry IP Scanner. Install and open the Angry IP Scanner and leave it at the default values and press the start button. The scanner will scan your local network to find the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. You can identify the IP address of the Raspberry Pi with its host name. As you can see here, this is the IP address of my Raspberry Pi. The next step is to go to your router settings and assign a static IP address for the Raspberry Pi. Or else, every time you restart your server, the IP address will be different. As you can see here, we can identify the MAC address of my Raspberry Pi from here. We'll be using MAC address based IP assignment for the Raspberry Pi. The following settings could be different in your router. First, enter the MAC address of the Raspberry Pi and then the IP address that you want to assign to it. Then click Assign IP. After that's done, restart both the Raspberry Pi and your router. Now open command prompt and type in the following command. SSH space pi at the IP address of the Raspberry Pi and press enter. And type in yes and press enter. It'll ask you to enter Raspberry Pi's password. The default password is Raspberry. Now we are logged into our Raspberry Pi. Now type in the following command. Sudo apt update, double and symbol, sudo apt upgrade and press enter. When prompted, type in Y and press enter and wait for it to finish. After that's done, do a reboot by typing in sudo reboot and press enter. Now let's install OpenMediaVault in our Raspberry Pi. For that, SSH back into the Raspberry Pi and go to this GitHub link given in the description. Scroll down and under the heading to skip network setup, copy and run the following commands one by one. This command will start installing OpenMediaVault in our Raspberry Pi. It's going to take a while, so go grab a cup of coffee and come back a while later. After that's done, our OpenMediaVault is installed and is ready for configuration. Now open your browser and type in the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. It'll take you to the OpenMediaVault admin login page. The username is admin and the default password is OpenMediaVault. First, let's change the default password. For that, click the settings icon and select the option Change Password. Enter the new password and click Save. Now let's configure our hard disk. For that, select the option Storage. From that, select Disk. Here the second one is my hard disk. Select it and click the Wipe button and confirm it. And select the option Quick. After that's done, select the option File System under Storage. Click the plus button and select the option Create. In the device section, select your hard disk from the drop-down and leave the type at ext4 and click Save. After that's done, let's mount the hard disk. In the file system option, select the hard disk from the drop-down and select 85% in usage warning threshold and click Save and confirm. Click on the tick icon to apply the configuration changes. After that's done, select the option User under User Management. Click on the plus icon and select the option Create. Enter your name. This will be your username. And also create a password and click Save. Now apply the configuration change. Now select the option Shared Folders under Storage and click on the plus icon and enter the name. This will be the name of your network folder. I'll name it Common Drive. In the file system option, select the hard disk from the drop-down list. And in the permission options, from the drop-down list, select the option Administrator Read-Write, User Read-Write, Others Read-Only and click Save. And apply the configuration change. After it's done, select the folder name and select the privileges option. Check the read-write option on your username and click Save. apply the configuration change. Now select SMB under the Services tab and select the option Settings. Check the Enabled checkbox and click Save. Apply the configuration change. Now select the option Shares. Click the plus button and check the Enable box. And in the Shared Folders option, select your folder name from the drop-down menu and click Save. And apply the configuration change. Our Raspberry Pi NAS is ready to use. Now let's see how to connect to our Raspberry Pi NAS through a Windows computer. First, open Control Panel and go to the Network and Sharing Center. Select the option Change Advanced Sharing Settings. And make sure the network discovery and file and printer sharing is turned on in your PC and click Save Changes. Now open this PC and select Network from the side menu. The Raspberry Pi should show up. Double click to open it. If you get this error when you try to access the Raspberry Pi, don't worry, there's another way to do it. Press the Windows plus R key, which will open the Run dialog box. In it, type /, followed by your Raspberry Pi's IP address, and click OK. It'll prompt you to enter your username and password, which you created while setting up OpenMediaVault. Make sure to check the option Remember Credentials. After it's connected, right-click on the folder and select the option Map Network Drive. Leave it at the default values and click Finish. Our Raspberry Pi is successfully connected to the PC. As you can see, file transfer works just fine. Now let's see how to connect to a NAS through an Android phone. For that, go to the Google Play Store and download File Manager Plus. Open it and click Remote and select the plus button to add our NAS. Select the option SMB from the menu. The host is the IP address of our NAS and enter the username and password and click OK. That's it. We are successfully connected to our NAS. If you have any doubts or face any issues, feel free to ask them down in the comments below. And if you like what we do, give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. This is Random Shashi signing off. Thank you for watching.